Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and today we're going to be taking a look at 5 built-in transitions in Final Cut Pro that you're either not using or not using correctly. Let's get into it. First up is the default cross-dissolve transition. Now, you're probably using this one, but did you know if you select this transition and go up to the video inspector, you can change the way it looks? For example, if you select shadows, the shadows of your second clip fade in first, followed by highlights. The highlights option does basically the opposite. You have quite a few options here to choose from for some very unique looks. Next up is the flow transition. If you just add this transition to 2 random clips, the results can look pretty funky. This can be a cool effect in all by itself, but the real magic of this transition is when it's used on talking head or interview shots. If you have a jump cut in your project that you need to hide, the flow transition can be a perfect way to do it. Now, this doesn't work every time, but if your 2 clips are fairly close in framing, this can make your cut completely disappear. When you add it to your timeline, Final Cut Pro analyzes the frames in your clips, and just like an optical flow, it creates new frames to make up the difference between your shots. What I find works best too is bringing the duration of this transition all the way down to 3 frames. Here's our cut before to connect with. In the same cut with the flow transition added to connect with. Number 3 on the list is the fade to color transition. This is similar to cross dissolve, except with this one, your first clip fades all the way out to black, then your second clip fades in. What's special about this transition is it can be used to signal your audience the passage of time. I use this for my tutorials all the time. When I need to show something that takes quite a bit of time, like rotoscoping, I'll just show the start of the process, then fade to black, and transition to the finished product. This visual cue tells my audience that time has passed, and they will subconsciously fill in the blanks and know the entire action has been completed. Next up is the wipe transition, and I love using this one for before and after shots. For example, I have the shot filmed using the log profile on my DJI Osmo Pocket. It's pretty flat and unappealing, but if I add a camera LUT to it and do some light color grading, I can make a shot look a lot better. Now, if I wanted to show the before and after of this shot, the wipe transition is a perfect tool for this. I'll just cut my clip somewhere close to the middle and disable the LUT and my color correction on the first clip. Next, I'll add the wipe transition, select it, and adjust a few parameters in the inspector window. Let's open the edge treatment drop-down menu, change the edge type to solid color, change the color to white, and bring down the border width. This gives us a nice before and after wipe, perfect for showing off changes made to your clip. The last transition, or collection of transitions I want to talk about today, is a scrapbook collection. You can find this in the stylized category of your transitions browser. These transitions are a bit different, and instead of using these as a simple transition between clips, you use them almost like a template to put together a still image slideshow. When you add one of these transitions to your timeline, you'll notice a few numbered yellow tags above your clips. These correspond directly with the image placement in your transition, so if you want to change the image displayed in a specific spot, you just click and drag the corresponding yellow marker over another image. If you want to learn how to build a complete scrapbook slideshow using these transitions, I did a dedicated video on this a long time ago. Click here to watch it, and I'll see you over there.